Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Keith Walker's hellish tales of heroin on the streets. The children are dying. Starring Shelley Berman. In the Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company and Lazy Boy Recliners. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Each year, thousands of people become addicted to heroin. Many of these are children, and many of them die. The streets of our cities are filled with those seeking a few moments of respite from the ills of the world. It is on these that organized crime preys. Join us now for The Children Are Dying.
Reacho! Anybody seen Reacho?
He's in the property room, Captain.
Well, don't stand there, Walensky. Get him.
Hey, Carter, get Reacho.
Right. 209, yell at Reacho.
Hey, Reacho, the captain wants you.
All right. I heard all of you. Doesn't anybody ever get up from around here?
Come on, Reacho. Hey, just
that.
Plant it. All right, cowboy. Explain.
Explain what?
Explain before I tear that lousy badge off your chest and throw it clear up to the park.
Walt, I am hearing you, but I don't know what you're talking about.
The horse race on the streets. You know I got a kid lying up at Bellevue on the edge of dying. What are you doing about it?
I got stringers all over this town. I've been up 48 hours trying to chase the connection down. Marty's on stakeout right now, and I'm tired of you blowing your buttons every time the commissioner sneezes. What's so funny?
I haven't heard you talk so much since they swore you in.
Terrific. I'm a comedian. Now that you're finished being entertained...
Shit. Okay. Maybe I'm a little rough, but if you'd seen the faces of that kid's family...
I saw them. I got there right after you left.
I wasn't told. Okay. Did you get anything?
No. The girl was still unconscious. Doctors don't have much hope for her.
Jelly called in. She'd only talk to you.
I'll go dig her up.
Do that, and then get some sleep.
Yeah, sure, while the children are dying. Apple pie, this is Mother. Do you read?
Yeah, Mother, I got you.
How's the spying going?
Rotten. I watched the school so long, some of the parents are going to call the cops soon.
Nothing, huh? Okay, go home and sack out. I'm going down to the Bowery and see a friendly wharf rat.
Tell Jelly hello from me. See you in the AM.
Right, Mother clear.
Can you spare a buck?
Yeah, getting a little ritzy, aren't you, Jelly?
Hey, Petey, good to see you. Hey, come on, buy me one for a little info.
One will never do you. Come on.
Petey, you're a real prince. A real prince. Shame about that kid.
How'd you hear about that?
Gets around, Petey. I got big ears. I never did go with that hard stuff. Joey, a bottle! Never did. Besides, you get all the highs you want out of this. Pete, you think the syndicate's in on all this?
I don't know. This town is more than one. Why?
Well, I hear these new guys talking with a tug captain. They're going to charter his tug tomorrow night to make a pickup.
Where?
Is it worth another bottle?
Yeah. That will keep you warm through the winter.
Gee, thanks, Peter. Pier 12, sometime after midnight.
Thanks, Jelly Baby. You hear other things, you call.
You bet. You be careful, Petey. These are the big boys.
So am I, Jelly.
Hello?
Yeah, this is Mother. Go ahead.
Marty. Bad news, Pete. The girl just died.
Ah, cop. Nobody invited you.
Lenny, move, or I'll wrap your ears so far around your head your nose will be smelling backwards.
Tough little Italian cop.
Where's Mr. Ross?
Here, I see it.
Is this all right, Benny? Let the man come in.
Okay, Mr. Rossi.
Pete, it is good to see you.
And you, Mr. Rossi, you are looking well.
I'm glad to say I feel well. And you, Pete, how's your mama?
She sends her love. A birthday party?
As always, a good woman. Yes, a party for the grandchild. It is a birthday in confirmation. Is there something you would like?
A few words.
Certainly. Come. I am getting old. It is good to watch the young.
Unless they die.
What is that?
A 13-year-old girl just died of an overdose laced with strychnine at Bellevue.
Sorry to hear that.
If I thought you had anything to do with it, I would bring much sorrow to you.
Is it good manners to threaten an old friend in his house?
No. I apologize. I'm angry and I let it show.
How may I help you?
Signora Rossi, I... Oh, excuse me. I did not know you had...
And an old friend, Victoria. This is Pete Riccio.
Hello, Mr. Riccio.
Hello. And it can be Pete.
And it can be Victoria. Forgive me for the intrusion. I will join the party.
Grazie. Un momento.
A beautiful friend, Mr. Rossi.
Yes, she's the daughter of Franco Prietelli.
Ah, the New Jersey family.
Yes. Now, the child is not my area, you understand.
I do. But I thought as a favor you could look into the matter.
We'll do what I can, if that is your request.
Thank you.
Go outside. Let the laughter of children living wash away your sorrow.
I can't.
Yes, do as I wish. As an old friend of your family.
All right. A moment, anyway.
A little wine, Pete?
Oh, Victoria. Yes, if you will join me.
I already poured.
Thanks.
You are sad.
It is good wine.
I see. You have asked Mr. Rossi for help?
He's an old friend. Our families have been together since the old country.
You are Italian?
And American.
Ah, then a toast to an American-Italian.
And to a lovely signora.
Signorina. Oh, the time has slipped from me. I must go. I only stayed to say goodbye to Signore Rossi.
And to sip wine with me.
Perhaps.
Perhaps then we could do it again.
I think I would like that. I live in the city.
Then tomorrow, if we both have the time.
Yes, I would like that. If you do not come as a policeman.
How did you know?
Benny.
I see. I'll try.
Good. Then wind up 7 at Graziella.
I look forward to it.
Pete, over here.
What do you got?
Follow me. Under the blanket.
Oh. Oh, that's it. That's it, man. That's the last straw.
Yeah, I know. But this time we got a witness. Here in the ambulance. Rosie, this is a friend. Pete Riccio.
Hello.
That your friend?
Yes. She died. She was my only friend in the world.
Oh, easy, Rosie, easy. Maybe we can be too. What happened? Tell Pete.
You won't like me.
Not at all, honey.
Money. Just sell other kids' horse.
How'd you get this stuff?
A van. A guy in a van to drop it off to us.
Was there a name on the van?
No, just a bunch of colors.
When would you get more?
I don't know. They only let us do it twice, and then we have to find others. Kathy was going to help. We needed the money.
You got a home, Rosie?
No, me and Kathy live on the street.
Okay, Marty. See that juvenile takes good care of her.
Okay. See you tonight at the pier.
Right.
Pete, we're in position.
Roger, I can hear him coming. Let's hope it's our tug.
Gotcha.
Marty, we got company coming. Cover them. Police, up there on deck. Freeze.
It's a van getting away.
Go after him. Don't do that. You're covered.
The van got away. Too quick for us.
Radio Harbor Patrol. 2-1 over the side. I got one of them.
Yeah, I can see. Well, I'll be.
Yeah, Mr. Rossi's soldier, Benny.
Nothing from the hospital. Benny's still in a coma.
I filed our reports. If we can find the two that jumped ship, we find our score.
Yeah, if. Looks like dead end.
Maybe, but I've got a date.
Check on Rossi?
Maybe, see it.
You ever sleep?
You ever sleep?
A friend asked me that same question earlier today. Only when I collapse.
That's what it looked like all through dinner. But you know, I can't remember when I've enjoyed someone more, despite the head nodding. Too bad you're a cop.
Sorry, but not about being a cop.
Strange. I would have thought your dad...
My dad wanted me to grow up outside the families. He felt it was time someone tried to make the streets golden.
A lovely thought. Even if it could never come true.
Victoria, what do you know about the drug traffic?
That it should be stopped, but who's going to do that?
Me. Is your father mixed up in it?
I thought this was to be a romantic dinner for two. Pete, listen to me. I like you. No, wait. Let me go on. I think you're a good cop. Rossi thinks so, too. But what the families do, well, it is their business. You could get hurt.
Maybe.
It is a maybe I do not like. I would like us to grow fonder of each other. Please. For me. Forget this business.
Victoria, I can't deny a feeling for you, but I think I'll do my job. Let me take you home.
No, I will take myself home, Pete. Believe me, I am not saying I am involved. Just that it is the business of others. Give it up. And if you do, I would like to see you again.
Good night, Victoria.
Good night, Pete.
Mr. Riccio.
Yes.
Telephone, sir. In the hall by the cashier.
Thanks. Give me the check.
Well, there is no check, Mr. Riccio. Compliments of the owner, Signora Priatelli.
Great. I should have guessed. Riccio.
Marty, I've got a message.
Shoot.
Shelley called. Has to see you now. Same place.
I'm on my way. Marty, I want a tail on Victoria Priatelli. Where are you?
Office. But I'll have a unit do it. She's still with you?
Probably in the garage getting a car, a black Mercedes.
Got it. See you later.
Shelley. Shelley, it's Pete Riccio.
Is he back here?
What's wrong? You okay?
I think so. Shattered, old pity cop.
Come here on the line. Shelley, who beat you up like that?
Couple of kids, would you believe it?
What happened?
I was sleeping, you know, minding my own sweet dreams, and suddenly I'm upside down, and two big kids just shaking me for change. But you'd have been proud of me. I got one in the eye. Did you ever throw a punch upside down? Anyway, they dropped me, and I tore the coat of one. Here.
Out of the light. Come on, Shelley. Shelley. Shelley.
That's like the movies. They got me.
Don't worry. Don't you worry. I'll get you to a hospital.
Take this.
What? All right. I know where you are. Come on out. Thanks, baby. This is Mother Queen.
Go ahead, Mother Queen.
Need an ambulance at 12 West 2nd. Also, do you know location on Marty Kendall?
10-4 in the ambulance. No location since last check-in on Kendall.
Roger, out.
Please reach you.
Ah, the friendly waiter.
Inside, cop. Mr. Rossi, like you said, here he is.
Come in, Pete.
sorry it has to be this way.
Me too. Where's the rest of your business?
Behind you, Pete.
Well, that wraps it up.
For you, it does.
How, Pete?
A friend took a miniature jelly container off a couple of your punks. They're the same name as the restaurant chain.
Yes, that was unfortunate.
Neat.
I would agree. Now, hold it.
Albert!
Forget it. Your waiter's sleeping on a job.
Mr. Rossi, Victoria, let's go.
Pete, it would have been nice, wouldn't it?
Oh, it was. Just short, that's all.
Rachel, Kendall, get in here.
Somebody ought to buy Walt a muffler.
He'd just blow it out.
Plant it.
You need to expand your vocabulary.
Listen, wise guy, just because you broke the case. Anyway, we picked up the kids from the list Rossi had.
Terrific. The streets are safe again.
No, they are not. Here.
What's that?
Somebody started a service to do away with wives.
Sir?
Quit it, Kendall. You're not even married. The two of you. Look into it.
Right.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
The Children Are Dying is an original radio drama written by Keith Walker. Shelley Berman was heard as Pete Rocio. Featured in the cast were Paul Sorensen, Peggy Weber, Peggy Walton, Jim Bowles, and Vic Perrin. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Coates, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.